This is the prosected part of the right upper limb, showing some of the muscles of the pectoral region, muscles of the arm, muscles of the forearm and the hand. This is the pectoralis major muscle. This is the sternocostal fibers of the pectoralis major muscle. This is the clavicular fibers of the pectoralis major muscle, and the both the fibers getting inserted in a bilaminar fashion at the lateral lip of the intertubercular sulcus at the shaft of the humerus. This one is the pectoralis minor muscle. This pectoralis minor muscle that is getting inserted over the coracoid process of the scapula. This is the serratus anterior muscle that is getting inserted over the medial border of the costal surface of the scapula. As you can see, this is the serratus anterior muscle, and that is getting inserted over the medial border of the costal surface of the scapula. This one is the medial border, jo andar ki taraf aa rahi hai, that is the medial border, and this one is the lateral border of the scapula. And this is the costal surface of the scapula, and this muscle is the subscapularis muscle, and this subscapularis muscle that takes origin from the medial 2/3 of the costal surface of the subscapularis fossa. This is the serratus anterior, and this muscle is the subscapularis muscle. Now coming to the muscles of the front of the arm. This is the front of the arm, and the muscles, these are the biceps brachii. As you can see, this is the long head of the bicep brachii. This long head of the bicep brachii that lies laterally, and the long head of the bicep brachii, it takes origin from the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. This is the short head of the bicep brachii, and the short head of the bicep brachii, it takes origin from the tip of the coracoid process. This is the tip of the coracoid process, and from the tip of the coracoid process, two muscles take origin. This is the short head of the bicep brachii. Along with it, the muscle lies this. This is the coracobrachialis. Short head of the bicep brachii along with the coracobrachialis. And this coracobrachialis muscle, it is pierced by the nerve. This nerve is the musculocutaneous nerve. That is the nerve of the front of the arm. And after piercing the coracobrachialis, and it supplies the bicep brachii. As you can see, this musculocutaneous nerve, after piercing the coracobrachialis, it is supplying the bicep brachii. It runs more downward, and it is supplying the brachialis. This is the musculocutaneous nerve piercing the coracobrachialis. It supplies the bicep brachii. It turns more downward, and it lies in between the biceps brachii and the brachialis. As you can see, this nerve is the musculocutaneous nerve. This nerve is the musculocutaneous nerve, and this musculocutaneous nerve that lies in between the bicep brachii and the, this is the brachialis. This is the musculocutaneous nerve, and after crossing the elbow joint, it continues as a lateral cutaneous nerve of the forearm. This triangular shaped hollow depression, as you can see, this triangular shaped hollow depression, this is the cubital fossa, and the boundaries of the cubital fossa. As you can see, the medial boundary that is formed by the lateral border of the pronator teres, and the lateral boundary that is formed by the medial border of the brachioradialis. This triangular shaped hollow depression, this is the cubital fossa. This triangular shaped boundary, that is the cubital fossa, and the base of the cubital fossa, that is formed by an imaginary line joining the medial epicondyle with the lateral epicondyle. And this muscle, this is the pronator teres. And this pronator teres, it is pierced by the nerve. The nerve is the median nerve. As you can see, here lies the nerve. This nerve is the median nerve, and this median nerve that is piercing the two heads of the pronator teres. The medial boundary that is formed by the lateral border of the pronator teres, and the lateral boundary that is formed by the medial border of the brachioradialis. This is the brachioradialis, and the content of the cubital fossa from the medial to the lateral aspect. The medial content of the cubital fossa, that's the median nerve. This median nerve, it pierces the two heads of the pronator teres. Medial to lateral is the brachial artery. This is the tendon of the biceps brachii. As you can see, this is the tendon of the biceps brachii, and the lateral content of the cubital fossa, as you can see, this is the radial nerve. The content of the cubital fossa from the medial to lateral aspect, that is the MBBR. M for median nerve, M for, this is the median nerve. Then this is the brachial artery. Next B is for the tendon of the biceps brachii, and this is the radial nerve. This nerve is the radial nerve, that is the lateral content of the cubital fossa. Now coming to the median nerve. This is the musculocutaneous nerve, and the musculocutaneous nerve, that has pierced the coracobrachialis, and it is supplying the coracobrachialis, bicep brachii, and the brachialis. And this nerve, this is the median nerve, and this median nerve, that is found by the lateral cord and the medial cord. Lateral and the medial cord, that is forming the median nerve. This median nerve, it runs downward, and it is one of the medial content of the cubital fossa. The muscles of the front of the forearm, and the muscles of the front of the forearm, these are the flexor muscles, and the common flexor origin, that is the medial epicondyle of the humerus. The medial epicondyle of the humerus, that is the common flexor origin, and there are the 5 superficial and the 3 deep muscles of the front of the forearm. And one of the superficial muscle, that is the, this, as you can see, that is running from the medial aspect to the lateral aspect, this is the pronator teres. And this pronator teres, that is forming the medial boundary of the cubital fossa. As you can see, this triangular shaped hollow depression, medially, that is found by the lateral boundary of the pronator teres, and laterally by the medial border of the brachioradialis. This triangular shaped fossa, this is the cubital fossa, and the content of the cubital fossa, we have already discussed, from the medial to lateral aspect. The content from the medial to lateral aspect, that is the MBBR. M for median nerve, B for brachial artery, next B is for the tendon of the biceps brachii, and R is for, this is the radial nerve. These are the content of the cubital fossa. And the front of the forearm, these are the flexor muscles. This is the pronator teres. And the pronator teres, it is pierced by the this nerve. The nerve is the median nerve. As you can see, here lies the nerve. And the, this median nerve, that is piercing the pronator teres. And the next flexor muscles of the front of the forearm, as you can see, that is running up to the second metacarpal. This is the flexor carpi radialis. Radius lies laterally at the thumb side. As you can see, the radius lies at the thumb side. This muscle is the flexor carpi radialis. And the other muscles are the, as you can see, this is the tendon of the palmaris longus. And the other muscles of the common of the front of the forearm, these are the flexor digitorum superficialis. These are the tendons of the flexor digitorum superficialis. These are the 4 tendons of the flexor digitorum superficialis. And deep to the flexor digitorum superficialis lies the tendon of the flexor digitorum profunda. Profunda means deep. And this muscle, this is the flexor carpi ulnaris, which is getting inserted over the 5th metacarpal. This is the, and this arising from the medial epicondyle. And this medial epicondyle, that is the common flexor origin, and it is getting inserted over the 5th metacarpal. This is the flexor carpi ulnaris. And the deep muscles of the front of the forearm, there are the flexor digitorum profunda. As you can see, the deep muscle, these are the flexor digitorum profunda, and this muscle, this is the pronator quadratus.